All right, everyone. Hi, my name is Erin Workman, and I'm the Executive Vice President here at LACM. I'm also the Department Head for the Music Business Program, which we're going to be talking about today. We're going to take a few minutes just to let people join us. Hi, everybody. Let us know you're here. Say hi. Put your chats in the, your comments in the chat, rather. And if you have any questions along the way, all throughout the session, you can just go ahead and send those in to us, and we'll make sure to answer. Today, we're going to be talking about making and maximizing your music business connections, which is a really large part of our industry, is developing those essential relationships. Hey, Emilio. All right, it's so great that people are starting to join here. We are so excited for this session today. I want to remind you, for anybody who is interested in the music business program at LACM, that we do have our applications up and available for spring 21 and for fall 21. So that's been always very exciting to see people start to really pursue their dreams and choose LACM as a place to do that. And we just are so honored. And hopefully we have some of our new incoming fall 2020 students who will join us in this session. If you're here, please, please say hello. We're getting very excited to meet you and work with you here coming up in October. So I know that people are still joining. I want to just go ahead and dive in. Again, my name is Erin, and I'm the Executive Vice President. And I do run two programs at the school, Music Business and Songwriting, which is just the most tremendous honor. And it's hard to pick one favorite part of my job. I really am so grateful every single day to get to wake up and do this amazing work. And most importantly, get to work with the most incredible students and faculty in the world. I mean, I've worked in a lot of different areas of the business, and I truly am blown away every day, both at the quality of our faculty and the level of engagement and professional expertise is just incredible. And then to see how our students really take all of this information and this knowledge in their schoolwork, and they take it out into the field, into the industry, and really just accomplish amazing things. And I'm very proud to call the guests that I have here today. It's a blend of students and alumni from the program, and I'm very proud to call them colleagues and friends and people that I deeply admire and respect. So I will be, I think let's go ahead and maybe dive in. Let's maybe bring on Shannon Galvin first, who is a current student in the program. And hey, Shannon. Hey,
how's it going?
It's going great. Thank you so much for doing this today. I really appreciate it.
Of course. Happy to be here.
Do you want to share just a little bit about yourself and maybe give us even some insight into why you chose to come to LACM, why you chose to pursue this path in the music industry?
Oh, sure. So I'm currently a student at LACM. I'm enrolled in the music business program. I'm in quarter 11. So there's 12 quarters total. That makes me a senior, I guess. I'm in the home stretch here.
Almost done.
Yeah, it's exciting. My current focus is artist management and a little bit of marketing as well. Those are my two major interests in the music business. So that's sort of the path that I'm on. And I really just chose LACM because the curriculum just seemed to be the most music business focused out of all the schools that I was looking at. A lot of other schools had a lot of general eds that were supposed to apply to what might be music business type classes, but it didn't really specifically address like a lot of the things that you need to know in the music business. And I found that the curriculum at LACM really does that. And it's held up to be true. I love the curriculum at the school. I've learned so much since coming here, and it's really put me in a position where I feel like when I graduate, I'm going to be ready to take everything on. So, yeah.
Absolutely. And, I always say about you that you win the prize for participated in the most internships of any student I have ever known, ever, thanks, anywhere, in your time. You've really, you are such an example of how to not just take part in what's provided to you in the curriculum and the faculty and the relationships, but how to take that and go above and beyond and really put that out into the industry immediately. So I don't want to be a spoiler. I know we're going to be talking later about some of your successes and some of your work opportunities and internships. So that'll be something to look forward to as we get a little later in the program today. But thanks, Shannon, for being here.
Absolutely. Glad to be here. Thank you.
All right. And let's go ahead and bring on Amber Dundee. Amber, there she is.
Hi.
So Amber is an alum of our program and has, you know, a really exciting story both about her.
Adam, hi.
Hey, Adam. And so true. Oh, good. Hello. So Amber, maybe tell us a little bit about yourself and again, what drew you to LACM and, you know, what has been maybe just a nutshell. I don't want to give away everything we're going to talk about, but a nutshell of what has been your experience moving from school and into the industry.
So, hi, everyone. My name is Amber. I actually originally, when I was living in Los Angeles, I started school at Musicians Institute, and I just got a certificate in the Independent Artist Program, and I kind of felt like I was originally trying to be an artist and I wanted to pursue being a singer. And I realized after taking like one music business class that they offered that there was so much that needed, that I felt was so important to learn as an artist. And that location was in Hollywood, which I wasn't super excited about. And so I was like, there has to be another school that offers a more extensive business program. And at the time, Los Angeles College of Music had just started their first music business program offering their associates and their bachelors. So I was like, you know what? Like, I really think that this is going to be an amazing program because following up on what Shannon said, their curriculum was incredible. And most of the time you find music business programs that are just all business, which is great. But at the same time, like I love singing and I love performing and I loved, you know, playing an instrument. And I was like, they mended this this course that had business classes as well as you get to perform with a band, you get to take songwriting, you get to take music theory, and just it had so much included, and I was really excited, and that's what kind of drew me into it, because I felt like if I do business, will I not be able to pursue being an artist too, or like will I have to choose one or the other? But that was really what drew me to LACM, is that they really offered both sides of it, which is where I kind of fell in love with it. And then I was their first music business graduate because we started off with, I think, a class of five, right, Erin?
It was, yeah.
A class of five. And then again, because there was a lot of music courses, I think that some of them were like, you know what, we kind of just want to stick with business. And they ended up leaving the program, which left me. So that was fun. And it was honestly the greatest thing that could have happened to me because all of my teachers were one-on-ones and it was a true blessing. So I think from doing that, Erin helped me really, really just blew my mind with when I graduated. She had so many connections and even my teachers had connections for me to find a job. And I think I went a week jobless out of school before I was fully hired by a company and really just working at it. And I also want to thank Adam because he was my first internship that I had with MDDN. Because he was like, you know what? You're my only student. Just come to work with me. So it was really a cool opportunity. So that's just kind of my story and journey with LACM.
Thank you so much for that. Yeah, you know, I had forgotten that you were like the lone survivor of that first group.
Yeah.
And, you know, for anybody who doesn't know, you know, we are obviously the program has grown exponentially since we started. Which is really exciting to see. And, you know, but we are a small school and we do that on purpose, really, because it really allows for us to give. We don't always intend to give one-on-one in every class, but we do get to know every single student. We do get to give individualized attention. And in the career planning, that becomes really critical because every person's path is different. every person's set of desires and goals and dreams and things they're trying to pursue are different. And so we really need to customize those plans for everybody. And Amber, I will say, you know, getting hired right off the bat, that is a massive tribute to you, because you moment you meet anyone, they just can see how amazing you are. And so, you know, I thank you for being the first grad of our program, because I think you set the tone and you set the bar really, really high for everybody who came after you.
So, thank you so much.
Absolutely. All right, let's go ahead and bring on Bella Elbaum. Is she there? Oh, there she is. Hi, Bella. I think you might be muted. It's okay. I do it constantly.
Sorry. There we go.
Appreciate it. So, hi. Thank you for being here. Appreciate it.
Thank you for having me.
So exciting. So tell a little bit of your story. Introduce yourself. Yeah. Why did you come to the school? I know you graduated recently. So what's been happening since then? Just nutshell version.
Yeah, for sure. So I started at LACM, now 4 years ago, because I just graduated. And before that, I was getting my degree in literature, which is great too. But my goal always was like, oh, cool, I'm going to work in the music industry, but like having writing skills is good too. and I just started, you know, I started doing a bit more research on music business programs across the country, and there's really kind of far and few between. And there's, I mean, like literally like maybe five schools. And I wasn't totally in love with a lot of the programs. And just like Wyatt, Amber, and Shannon said, the LACM definitely had the first music business program with a curriculum that I was actually really excited about and felt like I was going to learn what I wanted to learn. You know, there were a lot of music business programs that were more focused on like the production aspect of things and like the artist aspect of things. That's not really what I was looking for. So it took a lot of convincing. It was pretty difficult to get my family on board, but I'm also an incredibly stubborn person. And I would like to say I'm pretty convincing. And so kind of once I started in the program and started, you know, I really pushed myself and I started doing really well. And my family saw that it was like, oh, wow, you're good at this. You know what you want, which is, you know, you can't say the same for everyone. And everything just kind of started falling into place. There was definitely a bit more trust earned there. I mean, it's been really good. And I just graduated in March, like 2 weeks after shutdown, which has been kind of interesting. As I'm sure many of you know, there has been a lot of industry layoffs. So finding a job has been a little difficult, but that's not the end of the world for me. I have a lot of personal projects that I'm working on that I'm excited about. And weirdly enough, I've actually seen so much more done with the personal projects because there has been so much downtime. So it's kind of like once things do really start to open back up again, whenever that may be, I feel like we will actually be just, we'll hit the floor running. Like it's going to be really good. And I'm excited about that. So, yeah.
Oh, that's fantastic. Oh, and look, Kat is saying hi. Hi, Kat.
Hi, Kat.
No, that's so great. And I know we'll get into a little bit later, you know, ways that all of you have taken advantage of this time. And I know that sometimes seems a little strange because we all, I think, agree that this is not positive circumstances per se. No. But in our business, learning how to pivot, be versatile, learning how to work in a variety of scenarios, and often remote is the way that you need to deliver material and you need to collaborate. And so I think that it's really provided a push for all of us and a challenge for all of us. And thank goodness we are all creative thinkers and you guys are all solution oriented And that's what this business is about. And you know, also for you, Bella, kudos to you for convincing your family. And yes, you are convincing on a lot of levels, and that's a true asset to you in the business.
Oh, goodness, thank you.
But you have it, you know, you have the goods to back it up. So that's what matters.
That.
So, and you've worked so hard. All right, do we have Kayo here?
Hi.
There he is. Hi, Kayo. You made it.
Hi. I did. Here. Yay.
Very good. Well, what's I'll just up? Say to everyone who is just chiming in, Kayo like came directly from work. So talk about an example of hard work and still agreed to do this. Didn't even probably get a drink of water. So thank you so much. So Kayo, we've just been introducing ourselves, and do you want to just share a little bit about yourself, why you came to LACM, what your path has been? Just kind of a short abbreviated version foreshadowing what we're going to talk about later.
Yes, because my life is definitely an E! True Hollywood story. So before LACM, I'm a music artist. I sing, I write, I dance, I get down. I moved to LA to do the LA dream, right? You come in to be discovered, you come in to be noticed, you come in to just share your gift with the world. And when I moved to LA about 8 years ago, I came to do that. And, you know, a lot of ups and downs happened, and a lot of issues came about whenever the topic of music business was presented to me as an artist. There's a lot of terminology I didn't know, and a lot of mistakes that I've made, a lot of contracts I signed that I shouldn't have signed. And definitely a lot of people that I could have done without in my life, but they were there for purpose. So when I came to LACM back in 2018, I wanted to learn how the music industry works from the inside out so I can effectively learn how to brand my business as a music artist and ultimately, you know, work around, meet people, meet comrades, meet classmates who are in the business with me who are not so mean and also, you know, work in the business, you know, so I familiarize myself with connections and gain connections. That was my purpose when I got into the school. Now, the last quarter before I left the program, I realized my potential as not only a music artist, but the term entrepreneur kind of fit me way better. So I've learned so many avenues that I can take as far as income, as far as branding, as far as just getting out there. And LACM has kind of taught me that in trifold. I've partnered up with Erin. I like to call her Mama E because that's my mentor, personally. She knows that. but definitely, like, she's taught me how, you know, these are different streams that you can do for income. This is how you can get your brand out there. This is the road most travel. However, this is the road that you should take to get there because, you know, the road most travel is crowded, right? So we don't want to be on the 101. We want to be on the 134. Or we want to be on the 110 in Pasadena. So, you know, it's definitely helped me out with getting different avenues, and it's definitely helped me out even in today's time after I graduated, because I graduated in September. So, yeah, that's an abbreviation.
All right. That's so great. And I'm so excited for the session, you guys, this week, because I know we're going to really dive into what each of you are doing. And I know I've said it before, but I'll say it again. First of all, it just gives me such great joy to have you on this with me. And each of you in your own ways with your own stories and the way that you've approached this work has just shown yourself to be at such a high level of integrity and really representative of the industry member that we want to work with, right? Which is and we're going to be talking about relationships and how important finding those relationships and then building those and fostering those relationships in the industry and those connections. And sometimes we can reduce that to kind of the cold word of networking, right? Which is, mm-hmm. you know, it is the business terminology, but at the end of the day, it's about being a really good human. It's about working very hard. It's about putting the work in and day out. It's about asking for help when you need it. It's about all the things that I know we're going to be talking about. But each of you, I just want to thank you again for taking time to do this, number one. And just thank you for being who you are, because you inspire and motivate me every day, you know, in the work that I do, and seeing people come behind you and watch you, and you are mentoring others, whether you realize it or not. So I want to thank you for being such an incredible example to everybody who's coming behind you as well. I know, Adam. That's right. They are the future movers and shakers. I think they might be the current movers and shakers, actually, Adam. All right. So, you know, I just wanted to maybe throw one question out before we get into each of you sharing a little bit about the work that you've been doing. So if you were to advise either a new student or even a current student who's getting ready to kind of launch, or a prospective student, somebody who might be considering this path and unsure, or even just somebody who is entering the industry and feels a little lost, if there were a couple of do's and a couple of don'ts that you would impart as advice and encouragement, what would those be for you? Anyone?
I would say don't give up. Before I entered the program, I was very limited on knowing the kind of industry jobs that was in the music business. And when they first got dumped onto me, it was very overwhelming to the point where, okay, well, I don't know which way I want to go. Like, do I want to go this way? Do I want to go that way? I just want to give up. Don't give up. All questions will be answered. You will definitely have that aha moment and it will come to you and it will fit in so tightly and you will just progress forward. So that's what I would say, don't do. Believe in yourself.
All right. I love that.
Absolutely. I mean, I just bounce off of that and saying, you know, being a hustler, working hard, making your own opportunities, not waiting for things to come to you. That's probably first and foremost, in my mind at least, of the quality that you need to have as a music business professional, because this industry is always changing, and you might have a job one day and you might not have a job the next day, and it's sort of up to you to position yourself in a way so that, you know, you can always be ready for the next thing. And that starts at the school mm-hmm. level too. You know, and just making the decision to come to school, that's your decision, you know, that's your first step. So,
that's great.
Yeah, be a hustler.
I think, like, one of the things I've learned just by watching myself, watching other people, is like, definitely don't say no to anything. Unless it's like completely against your morals and ethics, then absolutely say no. But honestly, one of the things that I've learned is that kindness will pretty much take you anywhere. No one wants to work with someone with an attitude. Nobody wants to work with someone who is mean, who's rude, who's a know-it-all. Just be nice and be happy that you are given an opportunity, even if it's just running to go get coffee for mm-hmm. the label executives. Like, do it with the biggest grin on your face and don't mess up the coffee order.
Good advice.
Yeah, it's so funny to loop in what everyone said. I was going to say, people are always watching you, which is probably mm-hmm. the biggest lesson I've learned is, like, again, if you're going to run coffee, like, people will be like, are they going to be smiling when they get back after they had to do a 16 order coffee, like, you know? And it's all about, like, if you're positive and you're true to who you are, like, just make sure that you're aware that eyes are on you even when you think you're not. If you're a PA, even if you're just like on set to assist with one thing, like, everyone on the cast and crew is watching you to see just who you are and what you're doing and what you're about, and that's just huge. So always make sure you know people are watching you even when you think that they're not and that they don't care, but people are looking at you. They're snooping and seeing what you're doing.
Absolutely. And you know what? It kind of reminds me of, and I'm not sure how each of you received this when you first entered the program, but we tried from the beginning to really instill this message of show up, right? Mm-hmm. Like, you're going to have good days, you're going to have bad days, you're going to have days you feel like doing it and days you don't. But at the end of the day, if you are that person who is showing up, and you're going above and beyond and you're looking for the opportunities and you're asking the questions and you're seeking the answers, those are the people that even within, well, certainly within the context of the program, we instructors and any faculty member who's here, I'm sure will relate to this. We talk all the time about the people who are really impressive in the class. And we know that the feelings are cyclical, right? But actions are consistent. Actions line up with your character. And also we all falter and we all make mistakes and we all go through times where we're not our best self and we're not showing up to the best of our ability. And that's okay too. You know, as far as recognizing that and then turning that around. And we've all done that. I'm sure you've even seen me do it in the context of, you know, my work and my time teaching. We're all in this process together, but the fact that we're continually looking to the next person, and this is such a good core group to look at, how are they doing it? How are they getting through the challenge? How are they rising above? How are they maximizing that seemingly silly coffee run opportunity, right? Nothing is irrelevant. Nothing that you do is unimportant. And so I think, you know, and I know in this kind of pre-conversations we've had before this session, talking about kind of the nuts and bolts and the pieces that are not shiny, that nobody sees, the behind the scenes work and the, you know, the late nights and the, you know, the details and the difficult people and all those things that we deal with. You know, this will be a really great opportunity for you to share some of that. But I just want to say to anybody who's looking to go into this business is not about being perfect, but it is absolutely about be a sponge, absorb every single thing that you can, mistakes and otherwise. That's all so important. And, you know, each of you are such a great representation of I, of course, get the benefit of, and your faculty, seeing your trajectory of growth over a period of time. And it's really just been astounding, which is why I asked you to be here today. So I want to go ahead and dive into, because all of you have such great things to share about your journey, what you're working on, projects you're working on, and, you know, material that you can share that just showcases some of that. So I want to go ahead and start with Amber. Amber has a really, again, you know, she already kind of foreshadowed of the work that she's doing and has been doing since graduation, which is, I gotta say, in this music business where jobs turn over rather quickly sometimes, even that speaks volumes to you and how you show up to the work that you are at the same company and that you've elevated through that company over this time. So maybe I'm just gonna hand it over to you just to share about the work that you're doing.
Well, I got hired for a startup record label. It started as a record label, but we kind of grew into a multimedia company where Galen, my boss, he kind of saw that there was just so much that an artist needs that it's honestly amazing to just go to like a one-stop place to be like, we can do your videos, we can manage your music, we can do your publishing. So that's kind of what my company has developed into. It's called 3T Entertainment. But when I started with the company, I was just a production coordinator or like a project coordinator because we had three people that were on our team, which was literally Galen. He was the vice president. We had a guy named Joshua who was like head of production. And then we had myself and our director, Embryo, who you can also check out. He's going to be popping up. He directed the video that we're going to show you. But so it just started out literally as the four of us, five of us trying to figure out what we're going to do. We already had one artist that was signed with us. And then we had two that were kind of in the development stage, artist development stage. So it was really amazing that I got to start off with a small company with like smaller artists because we really got to focus on building their brands. There were so many like brand meetings, so many songwriting where I was in the studio just listening to the artists that we were with working on their records and things like that. And obviously being involved in their video production. But so I started with them in 2017 as a production coordinator and then just kind of moved my way up because I, again, just never said no to anything. So it's also funny too, when Galen hired me, he asked me, so where do you see yourself being in 5 years? And I was like, I really think when I was interning with Adam, I was in their tour marketing department. So I was like, I don't know. I kind of just like love traveling, but I also just love like traveling with bands. Like that just sounds amazing. So I think I'd want to be a tour manager. So that's kind of just what I told him at first. And he was like, well, we have no touring artists right now, but like fingers crossed that some of our artists will make it and like make it big and you'll be able to do a tour. And I was like, cool, no worries. Until then, I'm like here at your beck and call, whatever you need. So started off as the production coordinator and then eventually moved on to production production, doing production management, and then moved on to being a producer of music videos. And kind of crazy, but just kind of became a sponge, absorbed everything. And Galen was like, all right, do you want to produce? And I said, absolutely. Don't know what I'm doing, but you know what? I'm going to pretend I do. And I'm just going to, you know, ask questions. And luckily he lets me make mistakes, which is great because most bosses sometimes don't, but he is huge with learning. I know, you know, Erin, because you guys are good friends, but but yeah, so got into production. And then I guess this can be the moment where I show you one of the videos I produced. We made an artist named Isla, who is incredible. She's honestly one of my closest friends. And I, again, she's been in development for the whole time I've been working with her. So feels really close to me to be able to say that I was able to produce one of her videos and have been producing. So here is Tattoo Tears by Isla.
My tattoo tears burn when you're near. That's why I'm acting distant, and you'll see me reminiscing. Oh no, in your brain I won't drown. I can rain on my own. I'm wear a crown, throw a king off his throne. I had enough, turn off out of love, lost trust on the run. What? Tattoo tears, grab you. Tattoo tears. 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 I can't see them falling down my face. I can't see them falling down my face. So I'd rather. Tattoo tears, grab you. Tattoo tears. Tattoo tears, grab you. Tattoo tears.
So I wanted to give a little spiel about that. I guess wondering, what does a producer do? So when you're looking at that video, basically the producer, I hired all the cast, all the crew for who worked on lighting, whether it's the camera spinning, all of those things, wardrobe, hair and makeup. You're in charge of basically hiring all of that. You're given a specific budget, and it's here's the budget. Find the people who are qualified, go through hair and makeup tests, making sure that the artist likes who she's working with. The director will give you basically the overall idea of the video, what looks he wants, and you have to find people that are going to execute it. Obviously, you book them, and then the day of, you're managing the whole shoot. So, for example, the projector screen that's going with the different graphics on it, you hope that you show up and everything works correctly, but you know that never happens, actually.
Never.
So it's like moments where you have to spend 3 hours figuring out this building that we're in doesn't have enough power. So then you learn as a producer, now I need to know whenever we're booking locations to make sure that there is enough power in the building so that it can power this giant ton thing that's spinning and making graphics go. But yeah, so that's kind of the overall of what a producer does is we get the budget, we have to take care of it, make sure that we're not going over budget, we make sure that catering's there, we make sure everyone's fed, we make sure that everything's running on schedule. It's basically everything, so.
Yeah, what a tremendous job you did on that. And I've gotten to watch, you know, a lot of your work, and Amber, I'm just blown away by your talent, and these are not simple productions. No. So we're not talking about just like a simple little edit, huh? I mean, this is the real deal. So talk a little bit about, I know you said that when Galen asked you if you wanted to take it on and you're like, sure, I don't know what I'm doing, but how do you for yourself kind of bridge that gap between fear of the unknown because you haven't done it and really wanting to elevate your opportunities?
Well, I've always been someone who has known everything that I need is like within myself. I just have to allow myself to get there. And even though there's fear, it's more of, I know that the artist is looking at me. I know that my boss is looking at me. I know that there's people who are going to be relying on me. And I'm the type of person, I love being relied on. I don't know what it is. Sometimes it's really scary and very stressful taking on the burden of that on your shoulders. But that's something that I actually find to be one of my biggest strengths, is having that on me. So to know that I'm taking over a lot that I may have not done yet, I know that within myself, I'm capable of doing everything that I push myself to do. And there's definitely times where I have no idea what's going on, but it's like, you have to just be open to asking questions. And I'm such an executor and I want to solve an issue. So whenever there's something going on, there's always a solution. And basically I'm a very logical person in how my brain works. So I'm like, okay, there's these six things that we can do that can hopefully get this solved. And let's just go through them and see what works and what doesn't. And when something doesn't work, then that's when I have to go ask somebody, because I don't know. And it's okay to not know. It doesn't mean that you're bad at your job or that you aren't doing well. It's just like, if it's your first time, or even if you're super experienced in it, you're gonna experience things that you haven't experienced before, especially on a production. Because there's, we've had cast who showed up and then were like, I'm so sorry, I have to go because I have a family emergency. We've had literally camera guys who are mid shooting and they're like, I'm so sorry, I have to go, or I'm not feeling well. And you have to just think on your feet and figure it out. And that's like the biggest thing I've learned in the business, is just figure it out with a smile on your face and be happy about it, that you're in the, have the chance to figure it out with great people.
Yeah. That's so, I mean, I'm so glad that you're addressing, cause I think sometimes it's a little bit of a myth that, that you have to have it figured out before you take the job or before you. So yes, now, you know, I have taken jobs before that I had no business taking, and I've taken that too far. however, I've also taken jobs that I had that same fear and trepidation, but I also had a really great network. We're getting back to this connection, this network of relationships with people that I could call and say, hey, I don't know what I'm doing. I need to figure it out fast. And, you know, and it takes a lot of humility to recognize when you don't know something, and then to remove that layer of ego that says, I shouldn't ask for help. I shouldn't let anybody know. I don't know. So that, I'm so glad you addressed that, because I agree, you know, in the business, and when you're, especially as you're rising up through the business and you're taking on more and more opportunities, that kind of spirit of I can do this and critical thinking and problem solving is so essential.
And it makes you look, it makes you look bad when you pretend like you can do everything and then you're not executing it. Then people are like, you could just say you don't know how to do it.
Right, exactly.
You know, like, let's be honest and open, and people will hopefully help you out. Sometimes they don't too, but then you're like, all right, it's fine. I'm good on myself and I'm going to do it.
Yeah, yeah, absolutely. And then so you mentioned that you really thought you wanted to be doing tour management. So let's segue to this next exciting part.
So basically, one of our artists, Isla, she got signed with Empire, who is a huge R&B hip hop distribution and record label. And she shared her journey. If you go on YouTube, you can find, like, she does these little episodes. And basically, Galen came to me last year and was like, guess what? Well, technically, she's not my first tour. Technically, Johnny West is my tour, which is funny, because Johnny West, he went to LACM, as you guys may know, he was on American Idol. He's incredible, and he's actually signed to 3T Entertainment. We handle all his music. So, like, look at that. Even connections of, like, we love LACM, and, like, I know that I wouldn't be where I am without LACM, and, like, we see talent there, and we always want to bring that in. So I love working with Johnny, but so, yeah, Galen was like, all right, Johnny's hitting the road. Cool. That one was a simple, easy tour for the most part. And then he was like, all right, Isla's going to be in 300, 500 cap rooms all across America. You're going to be gone for a month. Are you ready to be the tour manager? And I remember calling my mom and being like, Mom, he asked me where I wanted to be in 5 years, and now I'm a tour manager in 3 years. What?
That's amazing.
And yeah, I really genuinely fell in love with doing tours. I mean, you're working with promoters every single day. You're working with the day of contacts to figure out how the sound's going to sound in the building, with getting the artist to the venue on time if she needs more rest, figuring out hotels. Like, basically tour management was I think is my specialty, but in the sense of I learned from production. So I understand how like a live show and a live production works. So when you take that on the road, you're basically with the artist and you're doing the same show every single night, but with different venues, different sounds, different setups. So
right. It
again keeps you on your toes, but at the end of the day, being on the road, especially with an artist who's fantastic, Isla's a sweetheart, it's just so much fun. So here's a behind the scenes, one of her episodes of her first tour, and I'll be kind of making some little commentary along the way.
All right.
So this show was in Georgia, and my parents drove all the way from North Carolina to support me because they were so excited. And this is actually her, I believe maybe her sixth or seventh show, so it's halfway through. And so you have this whole group on the road with you. So it's like being in charge with being a lovely babysitter for like 7-8 people. There's me. I got to take over doing merch as well, which was something new that I got to experience.
So it's like a this.
Nice.
With the train.
Nice.
Ooh. And then Isla had to plan out all her wardrobe like, for the whole month.
Like creepers, like black creepers, like the opening shot.
So less work than singing actual words.
Yeah, it is.
And it sounds
a lot of rehearsals. They changed a lot of things in the music and her vocals. Yeah. So a lot of good.
There's been regular performances
to hear Isla fucking bad ass, bro. Yeah, it's interesting. I be in here like y'all think I be joking. I literally be like, I'm serious, bro. Like she's going crazy. So,
yeah.
And it adds to her like thing of like, damn, she's really genuinely soulful,
artist, bro. She's going crazy. You see what I'm saying?
I'm nervous. It's my first show of tour. But it's like an excited nervous.
Every artist I've ever met on tour is so scared. Like it's, they have a lot of pressure on them to deliver.
Thank you, everybody in this room. This is nuts. I'm so nervous.
This was actually the first show of her tour. It was in San Francisco. And she had the whole entire record label there watching her to be like, we signed you for a reason, so show us what we signed you for. It was very intense.
And I could not do it without every single person in this room, and some more that aren't in this room, so I'm just grateful, and we're going to kill it.
If you notice, I'm beside her just like rocking back and forth because there's like 800 other things I'm still doing.
This is a long time coming, and seriously, every single one of you, like,
another amazing thing about being on tour is just seeing the energy of the fans react with the artists. It's incredible. And normally while she's performing, I'm actually running merch in the back of wherever. I mean, merch is set up different places, but I did run her merch majority of the time on tour. So while she was performing, because everything was handled, I was running merch.
Adventure of sharing, of winning, of some.
She also got chosen to be a YouTube featured artist, which is like a scholarship program that they do. So that's a little bit from this.
EP2, and we're here at YouTube to kick off our tour, man. It's fucking pretty special. Not too many artists get this type of opportunity. Not too many teams get this opportunity to be here. So thank you for that.
Thank you guys. I don't have a favorite show. It's too hard to pick, like, the shows are very different. Even between the three Texas shows, they're very different, like, audience-wise and, like, amount of people, like, capacity for each venue. But Texas has been amazing. Arizona was awesome.
Oh, also, something interesting, she had openers for some of her shows and then didn't have openers for other ones. So there were times where I was coordinating with other artists to come and hop on the tour. So that was interesting to coordinate and also taking care of them while they were there. And she sold out the Troubadour, which is something I've always wanted to experience, of being at the Troubadour and being there with an artist.
Yes, that is so exciting to see that. I could watch it all day. I really can. And I love, you know, I love getting to see you in action. And I love that you commented on the rocking back and forth. I do that too. And I have a million things in my mind and
yeah,
impatient to get going. Well, Amber, I can't say enough how proud I am of you and how inspired I am watching you work. And I know we didn't get to see each other all the time these days, but thank you so much for always staying in touch and always looking out for LACM talent. And I'm just so excited to see where you go from here.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
All right. So I know we'll be bringing you back a little later. Thanks, Amber. All right. So exciting to watch this. Kayo, are you there?
Everybody's, hi.
Hey, Kayo. All right, my friend. So I know you have some really great stuff to share with us. Maybe, and I know you touched on it already, as far as moving into the entrepreneurial space. Maybe talk a little bit about what that journey's been like for you, and then we can move into watching the video that you have to share for us.
Well, my experience from LACM to now was always unique, because here I am, this individual, I'm in both worlds, right? I'm in the world of music business, but I'm also the artist, which is a rare find. So after I took the program and I graduated, okay, what next, right? I know I have this music that I performed at LACM. I know people enjoy it much. I know I want to be a visual artist. I want to get my product out there. I want to start streaming. I want to, you know, basically restart my life as Kayo the brand. And it was just go time. So I filmed a music video in the beginning of this year, in January, for one of my songs that did really well when I performed it live at LACM. So that was one thing that I did that's great. In the midst of me being in LACM, I met my pack, as you would say, right? Mm-hmm. My alpha leader pack. And we were blessed enough to get a residency in Hollywood at a place called Cabo Al Cantina. And we have this company called Hidden Gems, where we were able to feature not only artists like myself, but other artists that were in LACM as well. And it wasn't at that moment in time, it wasn't about the numbers or the politics of the business. It was about just going there, having a great time, performing your heart out, and letting the world know that you can do what you can do. So I was able to have that, of course, in my life spectrum. And also I was able to start my own other company called The Third, which helps other artists with their branding, which helps artists with choreography, which helps, we spoke about that, which helps stage performance, anything, any nook and cranny to help you be the best you, I'm able to help you with and go. So I have three companies under my name since me graduating that I've been manifesting. And then COVID happened, of course, and they shut most of that down. Ooh. So now it goes, okay, what next, right? I released this video. It got really great reviews. I was featured in Voyage LA magazine. I was featured on a podcast by a friend of mine, Exploring the Talent. Like, things were still moving. So what do you do now? Because you can't perform. And that was the heart of my mate. And it got a little discouraging at first, but then I remember I would speak to my mentor, and she always reminded me of the slow burn that I am in. So in the midst of this pandemic, I had to rely on my networking game. I had to connect with people who was just sitting around thinking probably the same things that I've been thinking. And I can tell you that before I got into the program, before I even went to LACM, I knew no one professionally that had good credit with regard to the industry. So I didn't know any credible producers. I didn't know any credible DJs. I didn't know no sound tech engineers. I didn't know no PR people. I didn't know no managers, nothing. I can say now that I've built a wonderful, wonderful, wonderful network of producers. I have audio engineers, like the top of my head. I've had 7 producers contact me since I've dropped Famous the music video, wanting to work with me, even one in New Zealand. And that just blew my mind away. I have a PR person now that's helping me with branding up things of my company. I have a ton of dancers in the back way, and I have 3 or 4 videographers I'm working with a project. And, you know, that to me is a blessing because, again, it's the name and the nature of the game to network with different people and try to understand we're all trying to win together. And it definitely does take a village to raise a child. So that's what I've been doing. And as the stage evolves and goes, when September comes around, I am involved in 3 projects. I'm going to be shooting another music video. Yay, go me, for my song Type Dizzy, which I recorded in LACM. Me and a couple of my LACM classmates who are really good friends of mine, shout out to Dominique and Joseph, or DJ Track Runner. We are actually doing an online TV show on top of a Hollywood, on top of a rooftop in Hollywood Boulevard. It's going to be called Above the Boulevard. And we're just going to be sitting around talking about politics and music. Well, not politics, but music things, social and, you know, personal items. And we're just going to keep it funny, keep it light. And definitely going to have some vibes there. And then also my company, The Third, has 2 music video projects with other artists that I'm blessed to be the creative director for. So I'm a little busy.
You've been busy. That's so exciting. And, you know, I'm kind of, you know, reflecting on some of your moments in your journey. And one thing that always stood out to me about you is you did not ever settle for less than what you really wanted, even if you didn't know what you really wanted at that moment, right? Which is such an important thing to note, because I mean, how many times were you in my office just saying, this isn't enough, or this isn't, you know, I'm not quite getting, and searching and pushing, and to see you really just, you know, expand tenfold in your vision and with all of your ventures. And I don't know if everybody knows here, but Kaya is also a tremendous, tremendous choreographer, in addition to be just so multi-talented. So it's so exciting for me to see you put all of those things. And I know that was one of the questions. Can I do everything I want to do, or do I have to pick? And I really love that you have, you know, worked so hard to find that holistic space creatively in business, that you can really tap into every single thing that you've been, you know, really fortunate to have as gifts. So well done. Very
proud. Thank you. I appreciate that. I had an aha moment when I was shooting Famous, and I was partnering up. Like, I had a director and then I had a videographer, and the way we were talking about him was really great. But there's a moment, and it's actually in my sizzle reel that I have, when one of my dancers asked me for direction. I was like, well, if you just go over there and hit this over there so the camera can go over here. He's like, thank you so much, boss. It hit me like, oh my God, I am a boss.
Like, yes, you
really
are.
Happening. Like, I really yes, am a boss. Are. I've never been called that before. So that was an aha moment for me. And then when I went to go help the videographer with the edits, he looked at me and he was like, you know what, Kyle, like, I've never had any artist know what they are talking about when it comes to edits and the music language and the terms. Like, you legitimately know it all. And I'm like, no, I don't know it all. I don't know just some. And he's like, but no. That's a blessing to have. I can talk to you like I talk to an artist manager, and it's all in the same. And, you know, it's just like, that's my LACM talk. That's what I've learned from my school. So, like, yeah, it's a different experience for me now out there in the world doing this music thing and doing this entrepreneur thing and helping out other artists and, you know, just having fun with it and just being positive and being my joyful, bright self. You know, you can never
Hey, always brightens my day. Always. All right. Well, I'm so excited to see the video that you're going to share with us. You want to tell us a little bit about it?
Okay. So the first video I'm going to show you, of course, is the music video Famous. The song is just a very interesting song. It's pretty much an ode to, I guess, it's a way of self-love and self-empowerment. And, you know, it basically, it's a fun song. It has a retro sound to it. And I wanted to pay homage to the 80s and the 90s, which is the generations that I was able to, you know, be raised and grew up in. So I was inspired by the movie Fame, Leroy Jackson. And that's where my 80s vibe comes from. And I was inspired by the 90s movie House Party, which you will see also in the video. And it's basically, the song is, if you want to be famous, you have to sleep with me to get to the top. And it's artificial, as superficial as it sounds, it's basically like I'm that important in my life that if you really want to get to where I'm at, you have to mess with me. And it was so much fun doing this video. This video was a 7-hour shoot, which is not normal because normally videos don't last a lot longer than that, but we was really on it. And we had so much fun doing it. The characters, the dancing, it was just a lot of fun. And people keep commenting me on my wig because I had a Rick James like curly wig and the dancing style. It was just really great style. Without further ado, here is my music video, Famous.
All right.
Let's go, let's rock. I was wondering, are you ready for it? A private audition for you? It's my time to clock me. So high class to jock me. Miracle child, they can't believe. Sexy swag, I put them in lead. Put them in the room, let's have a seat. Don't hold them back, get off me. Step in the room, my own beat. Lost in your eyes, I know you want me. Can you hear the one more? Get that, go down to the floor. We're about that life, we give it all back, all the hammer time. Only got one life, better keep that shit tight. Around you, what you gon' do, what you gon' do, gon' do. If you wanna see how far I can go, I got a room in the Hilton, me and you can take this shit, don't go. Let it soak in, let it soak in, it's true. And all up to you to claim it, get famous.
I just realized I was muted. Sorry. I love it. That's so much fun. It's so much fun.
That wig was so itchy.
I bet. For 7 hours too. I can't quite fathom that.
Yeah, it was like, yeah, it was really cool. Fun fact about the videos, the lady who was in the gym, she was my Jane Fonda. Today's her birthday, actually. Her name is Amanda. She had the set laughing the whole time. Like she could not take her role seriously enough. And then some of my dancers, one of my dancers to the right, the guy with the dreads, he's actually singer Anthony Hamilton's son, Romero.
Oh, wow.
So
wow.
Yeah, he did a favor for me. And then there's a lot of students in LACMS mm-hmm. actually in that video.
I saw
that. Did it on the whim. Yeah. And again,
yeah.
I guess people love the energy and the energy I bring and they just want to be around me. So in fact, that a lot of the extras and actually the dancing stuff actually did that for me for free. So that
it's right relationships,
there,
right?
Yeah, yeah. It really helped my pockets and it helped my confidence so much. Like, and they stayed the whole entire time doing it. So that was really, 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 really great experience for me. Really great experience.
I love it. I love it. Well, yeah, you can really tell a lot about what you're putting out to the world and the way that you work and the way that you live when you see people who are attracted to that and people who just want to be able to be a part of, you know, the work that you're doing. So that doesn't surprise me at all, knowing you, my friend. And did you have something else that you wanted to share with us as well? Oh, I think you might have muted. See, we're taking turns.
I'm here. Sorry. So I had to do a scissor reel for consideration to perform out the country, actually. And I never did a scissor reel before in my life, but then I had to go back in my mind and think about one of the classes that I've taken. And I was like, you know what? I took this. Adam will look at me like I'm crazy if I don't do the scissor reel. So boom, I'm going to do it. So I did this scissor reel to pretty much sum up my year of 2019 and things that I've done. And I actually used the song Famous because Famous was out already, right? So why not use that for marketing? And I created the scissor reel of my performances that I've done. Back at LACM, I did behind the scenes for the Famous music video, and it's fun. It's just fun. And the moment that I spoke about earlier, when Romero was the guy to ask something, he was like, "Okay, boss," and I was just like, "Oh, that was the aha moment that I was talking about." So
I love it.
There's behind the scenes, fun, fun, fun.
Let's go, let's rock. I was wondering, are you ready for it? A private audition for you? It's my time to clock me. So high class to jock me. Miracle child to keep me. See, glad I put him in here. Get her in the room, let's have a seat. Don't hold him back, it over me. Step in the room, my own beat. Look in your eyes, I know you want me. Take it back, you're the one who knows. Get that, go down to the floor. We're about that life, we give it all back, all the hammer time. Only got one life. Better keep that shit quiet. If you wanna see how far I can go, I got a room in the Hilton, me and you can take this shit to go. Let it soak in, let it soak in, it's true. And all up to you to claim it, get famous.
And you're in the mood, do wrong, hope to. And you're in.
I love it. I love it. And some of those scenes, you know, of course, I had the honor of working with you in your performances. And I just, that alone, that experience and seeing how you went from, I don't even know what I should do, to these massive shows with dancers. Your vision has always been so huge. And not just that, but you've also invested so much time and energy to create those solutions and to actually go after that vision and see it come to fruition. So congratulations, Kyle, on all your successes.
Thank you.
Cannot wait to just see where you go from here. So I know I'm going to bring you back in a few minutes just to recap and say goodbye, but thank you so much for sharing with us. You're amazing. Appreciate it. All right. I love this. So we're going to get into it. We have two more guests, and then we're going to leave you with just a few parting words. But I would like to ask Bella to rejoin. There she is. Hey, Bella.
Hey.
Hey. So, you know, everybody's story is a little bit different, and I love that each of you are kind of showcasing different things. I know you've been working on some management projects, correct?
Yeah. Yeah.
You want to share a little bit about that and anything else you'd like since you graduated in March?
Yeah, for sure. Yeah. So I actually went into school thinking I wanted to like have my own independent record label, all that. And then once I took my first management class, which I believe was the first quarter, I definitely started realizing that was the way to go. And actually, taking classes with Pablo was really solidifying the idea for me because he talked like really positively about it. And the way he talked about it made me realize more that that just kind of fit with who I am as a person. It's such a personal job, and I do really like that you kind of take on a lot of different roles. So you get to kind of be pulled in a lot of directions in a good way. So yeah, I work with a band called Cheer Up Club. They're like an indie alt rock band. You know, it's like, if I were to compare them to someone, I'd say if you put like Pavement, Pixies, Buzzcocks, and like Dismemberment Plan into a blender, that's what they would be.
That's so good. It's so true.
Yeah. Yeah. And they're awesome. Ethan's like one of my favorite songwriters. I think he's really good. And they are one of the few artists I know that are just constantly writing. Like literally a song, at least a few songs like a week easily. Yeah. And they're not all like, they're not all gonna be, you know, hits, of course, but like that, that like muscle is constantly being trained, which is great. And so it's nice that I don't really have that issue. But I know some people and some managers struggle with where it's like you have to push your artist sometimes to write. They have a really strong brand and a really strong image, and they know what they want. They're definitely pretty mature, which is cool, and they're pretty easy to work with.
I would say that like the most difficult thing is that Ethan in particular is such a perfectionist that things can take a little bit of a longer time, but when they're done, it's like, dang, okay, that looks really good. So yeah, I'm really excited. They have a record out, and it's on Spotify, Apple Music, YouTube, whatever you listen to. We're releasing a single on September 24th, I believe. And it's a new song. It's called In the Morning. It's just going to be kind of like a one-off. Everything's going to be donated to this homeless shelter, a women's homeless shelter in downtown on Skid Row. Wow. Yeah. And so we're working with a publicist too, which I'm excited about. And everything's definitely been feeling really good with all of that. And I kind of like that the song's kind of taken on a bit of a different form because it's not the full band, because everyone's gone in a completely different direction right now because everyone's kind of been displaced. And so it's definitely still very true to the sound and brand that is Cheer Club. But it does offer something a little different, which is exciting. So I'm really looking forward to that. Supposed to go out on tour in May. That quickly got shut down, obviously. So yeah, now we're kind of looking to just release content, work on basically just having all our ducks in a row, for when we can go out and play shows. Just trying to network behind a screen, which is kind of interesting because I think just sending out emails before it's a tactic that works, but it's hard. But now people kind of have to be on their computers more so than before. So it's definitely better. As far as all the Cheer Up Club stuff, that's pretty much like where we're at. Just trying to create as much as possible in the time that we have. And I feel like we've done a lot more in the past 6 months than we have, you know, in like the year before. And maybe I'm not giving us enough credit, but it's just different work is the better way to say it.
Well, and I've, you know, of course gotten to watch you, and we should say that this is an alum band too. So we're especially proud of them at LACM. And you know, the work that you in particular have done with them to really, they've always been incredible musically, but the work that you've done to really accelerate their business opportunities and their visibility has been really impressive to watch. Mm-hmm. So I would love for everybody just to get a chance to hear a little bit. Do we want to share a bit of the video or their past video, I guess, right?
This is their last release. So it's an old video. There's going to be a new one that's going to come out once again in September. Like I said, YouTube, all that, Facebook, Instagram. And then this one is just a 1 minute teaser that we did for a single release that they did, I want to say a little over a year ago. It was through the school label, which I had been part of like literally since day one.
Which is called 370 Music Group. Just so you know.
So for any music business students that are coming in, that is also definitely a really big perk of the school, is that you do get label experience. So I would 100% encourage people to take advantage of that. Let me get this going. Everyone able to see everything?
I got this weird It wakes me up from sleep, but wish I could switch. Prescriptions for a key to your mind. Got it all locked down. A fake smile, but it feels more like a frown. But I don't know what you're trying to say with crosswords. I don't know how to play, and it brings me down. Cause the sky out.
I love that. So fun.
Yeah.
So fun. They're so great.
Yeah. I feel like that's, I mean, they're definitely a really visual band.
Yes.
Which I love. And so just a minute kind of gives you an idea of what you're going to get with them.
Yeah.
And that's been really fun. I've been kind of, because they're such a visual band, I've been teaching myself Facebook ads.
Okay, good.
And we've been just kind of testing different ads with different visuals that they've come up with. And man, the ads are scary because you can get into like really nitty gritty things, but they're so powerful and like really, really effective. And so that is definitely something that I would encourage people to also kind of look into as well. It's a really, really good tool to have in your pocket for your artists and releases, or if you're an artist yourself, it's like, that's a pretty essential one to learn.
Absolutely. Yeah. And I imagine in some of the classes, I always think about this, and certainly this was, you know, something I experienced in my own schooling, but where you learn things along the way in the classes, but then when you really put that into practice and you start to see kind of the power behind the information and the knowledge, and then you bring in even new technology that's been developed since and new outlets, it's really, that's where you really see kind of that power of the connection between what you're learning in school and how you adapt that and take that out, which, you know, people do to varying degrees of success. And it takes a lot of hard work. So I love watching how you just hustle and you pinpoint those areas that you need to learn and you go after it. And like we were talking about, you know, earlier, that you're kind of just asking those questions. And if you don't know it, you're going out and you're finding it. And I just want to applaud you for that. It's not easy.
Yeah. That's definitely, that's important. Asking questions is great, but sometimes they will not be answered. And I've definitely learned that like fake it till you make it is pretty big. I mean, I even remember one of my last internships, there were things that would come up and they would let me sit in on marketing meetings and things would come up and I would like text Adam and I would be like, what does this mean? I've never heard of this term. And I want to look like I know what I'm talking about. And like, there is definitely a lot of stuff that like you need to just do and learn on the fly.
Yeah.
Which is kind of intense and can be super intimidating. But I think that especially when you're at the beginning of your career with music, even with all the knowledge that I have, I still feel like I have so much more to learn, and I will just
Stop
learning because it's just, it's constantly changing. Like you know, in 2 years, it's not going to be Facebook ads. It'll be some other type of advertising that you need to really get good at.
And that's the thing. I think when you embrace that, I mean, to me, I've always felt like if I stop learning, I'm sliding backwards, you know, but embracing that's very exciting too. That's one of the things I love about our business is that every single day there's something new or many things that are new to learn and adapt to. So yeah, your ability to do that is going to serve you really, really well.
Yeah. Thank you. Yeah. I hope so.
No, it will. Well, thank you, Bella, for telling your story and sharing with us. And we're really excited for Cheer Up Club's next release. And just stay in touch with every single thing you're doing, please.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.
All right. Thanks, Bella. Okay. And now we have Shannon Galvin, who's a current student.
Hey.
And is our internship rock star, among other things. So, hey, Shannon, you want to just dive in and talk about your work and what you're up to?
Sure. So let's see. Should I go through like sort of the journey a little bit, or do
sure,
you want me
please.
To say? Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, I mean, I'll try and make this really quick because I'm short on time. But I started out thinking I wanted to be in music production. So I went to school for music production, learned that, quickly figured out I didn't want to spend 13 hours a day in the studio, that I liked people too much, and that I'd rather be outside a little bit. So pivoted and knew I still wanted to be in music. So I thought, hey, music business, I have plenty of friends who are incredible artists and their music is falling on deaf ears. And this was when like SoundCloud was really big and they were just putting music up on SoundCloud and expecting to be discovered. And I was like, that's not the case. That's not how it's worked. You know,
right.
You're not going to make it like that and you need help. So decided that, yeah, I wanted to probably be an artist manager and had to figure out, well, what's my next step? And decided to go to community college to get some credits out of the way before getting my bachelor's degree. So I ended up getting an associate's in media arts, so doing graphic design, Photoshop, web design, stuff like that. And the thought process behind that was basically, nowadays, you have to be so self-sufficient, especially starting out when you're on a very tight budget. The more that you can offer your artists as an artist manager, the better that you are. So, yeah, I just was like, hey, I'm not going to have the money to hire all these people out. I need to be able to do a lot of this stuff myself. So that was the thought process behind that. Anyways, got that and then found LACM, which I'm so happy about, because when I started at LACM in the music business program, honestly, I did not know very much at all about the music business. I had maybe read a couple of books and thought, yeah, this makes sense. But after taking all the classes there and making like close relationships with the teachers and faculty and just, you know, picking their brains, I've learned so much. And also, you know, we have the school label, and in working at the school label, that's how I was able to first position myself to get my first internship. So I was finally able to put something on my resume that was music related, you know, music focused, not just, you know, I'm a server at a restaurant. No one's going to hire me for that. So I ended up getting my first internship doing management, A&R, and administrative work. And basically, through just showing up every day, working hard, being passionate about music, and just like being a, you know, nice person, not having an ego, people, they like wanted to have my back. So when it came time that my internship was up, I already had people that were basically helping line up my next one and the one after that. And that's basically how I've gotten to the point where I've had like 5 now. And, you know, and having all these different internships and seeing these different companies, big and small, it's taught me a lot about the business, which is great. And I've learned a lot of different things and in other avenues too, like marketing and sales and all sorts of stuff. But at the end of the day, all stuff that I could take back to use sort of in my own projects and things that I'm developing. So one of those is I work with this artist, Zeno, who I met through the school label, and he's an artist that I've been working with now for about a year. I've been developing him and basically helping with any of the holes sort of that he needs filling in his career, and getting him from basically the grounds up to, you know, groundbreaking, if you will. Like he doesn't have anything out yet, which is cool, because I love this development phase where you can really just kind of, I don't know, get in the nitty gritty and like really, I don't want to say perfect things, because, you know, perfect isn't, it's not a real thing. And if you chase perfect, you're going to be running in circles for a very long time, which is something I've had to learn along the way too. But yeah, it's been great. We've been working on production, recording. We have 2 recording sessions next week. music video, which actually we can share here. But essentially, yeah, for this music video for his first single that we're going to drop, I was able to get a director and producer and her film team to agree to basically do this for free. All we had to pay for was the equipment, the rentals, and all the props and things that we needed, catering, crafty. And talking about networking, it's funny because this director is the same one that directed Cheer Up Club's Geezer music video, which we just saw prior. And Bella was the one who made the connection for me for that director. Wow. So again, you know, like,
okay,
networking, you know, keep connections, be a decent person, like, and always be looking for the next opportunity. But anyways, yeah, this music video here, this is Denim Daddy by Zeno.
Love it.
It still needs a little bit of editing and coloring. It's not out yet. He doesn't have anything out yet, but you'll get the gist.
Driving to your house, windows down, I've never felt the wind like this. Hot summer air, you're lying there, and I'm waiting for that kiss I miss. I dream about the way you say my name, and how good you look in blue. I love it when your lips caress my skin, you're so hot and damn. Saw you standing on the shore with your heart in the sand. My future flashed before my eyes, and it's in your hands. Denim, denim jeans. I dig the way you look when you're looking at me. Chain smoking all your love in a plain white tee. I'd wait a million years, would you wait for me?
Well, what a great sneak peek. I, of course, have gotten to see that, and it's just one of my absolute favorites. I'm so excited for when that comes out. Do we have any idea of release date, or are we still?
We're still working on that.
Okay, all right.
Part of that has to do with the fact that we're coming up on quarter four, and we're figuring out whether or not we want to be releasing in quarter four, which is something, if you're going to enroll in the music business program, you'll figure out why quarter four is potentially not a good idea. not yet, but yeah,
I can't wait. And you know, I too have been able to just see you and Zeno develop this project, and I remember the day you decided to come on board and work with Zeno, and just watching how you've handled that and the two of you working together has just been really powerful to watch. And so thank you so much for sharing all of that, Shannon. I know we have to wrap this up. I wanted to bring everybody back, if we could, just for some quick parting words. Everybody, thank you so much for doing this again. For audience out there, thank you for joining us. I hope you have been able to get some questions answered. For more information, there's our website there, and you can also get in touch with our admissions team, who would be very happy to talk to you about the program. So guys, before we go, do you have any parting words, any last things to say for people to kind of take away and remember?
You are more powerful than you think you are. Mm-hmm. Never underestimate yourself, ever. Okay. Ever.
And just keep on learning. Like, you're just keep learning. Even as we get older and older, we're always going to learn new things. So,
yep.
Take advantage of your teachers, faculty, everything that's thrown your way at school, every single class that you have, whether it's royalty accounting or it's management. They're equally as important. So give 110% with everything.
And I'd say take risks. Nothing in this life that's worth doing is going to be easy. And there's always going to be some fear around it, but just take a leap of faith because I guarantee it's going to be worth it in the end.
Yeah.
100%. Well, I could not say it any better, you guys. There's nothing that tells people what this program is all about, tells people what this industry is all about, better than showcasing people like yourselves who are doing everything you just said. You're doing it. You're showing it. You're showing up every day and setting that bar high for everyone. And you're doing it with a smile, and you're all amazing humans that we like to hang out with, which is a huge bonus, right? And so developing these relationships, you know, making these connections, you know, at the school, of course, we bring a lot of guests into the school for you to meet, but you also get to go out into the industry. And then I love watching how each of you has taken those connections and really your network has blossomed. Your activities are incredible. Your hustle is incredible to watch. And I'm just inspired every day. So I want to thank you again for doing this and for sharing with us. And hopefully we get to do it again soon.
Yeah.
Yeah. Thank you for having us.
All right, everyone. Take good care.
You too.
All right.